Did you know that 90% of our drinking water comes from the Colorado River, one of the cleanest water sources in North America? My name is Xiaoping Zhou. I am a senior hydrologist for the Southern Nevada Water Authority, protecting environments and deliver clean, safe water to the millions of people in Las Vegas Valley is one of my most important jobs. One way we do that is by cleaning the water after we take it out of the Lake Mead, the reservoir in which it's stored, before delivering it to your home. I know that you probably don't like tests very much, but as a hydrologist focusing on water quality, tests are a very important part of my job. Before sending water to your home, we must test water to ensure it is safe to drink. We also test water in Lake Mead and Las Vegas Wash to make sure it's safe for wildlife. Some of the things we regularly measure to determine that water is safe are dissolved oxygen, temperature, pH, and conductivity. Some of you may be scratching your head after hearing me say oxygen. Is there really oxygen in our water? There absolutely is. It's just dissolved, similar to the oxygen in your bloodstream that keep you alive, flowing from your lungs to your organs. That's how fish are able to live underwater. Their gills, filtered oxygen from the water, is then carried to their organs. Healthy water has enough dissolved oxygen to keep the fish and other organisms that live there alive. I mentioned that we also measure temperature. Warm water holds less oxygen than cold water. Another important item or parameter that we measure is called conductivity, which is a measurement of the amount of the minerals, including salt, that are in the water. In fresh water, like Lake Mead, too much salt can be hazardous to the creatures that live there. High levels of conductivity can also indicate that water has traveled a long distance, experienced high evaporation, or being contaminated by some kind of a pollutant. The last parameter I want to talk about is called pH. pH measures the amount of the hydrogen present in the liquid on a scale of 1 to 14. Solutions with more hydrogen are called acidic. A high acid level is between 1 and 4. Acidic solutions closer to 1 can cause severe burns to our skin. Solutions with less hydrogen are called basic, with a highly basic solution measuring from about 10 to 14. Strangely enough, solutions with a pH near 14 can also cause severe burns. The scale is logarithmic, meaning a decrease of just 1 makes the solution 10 times more acidic, where a decrease of 2 makes 100 times more acidic. Either way, too much acid or too much base are both very bad for rivers and lakes. Healthy lakes and rivers have a pH that's close to middle between acidic and basic. We call that neutral or a value of 7. To better understand pH, I have a few things here that we can measure. A Coke, some leftover morning coffee, and Las Vegas wash water. To help us measure the pH of each of these solutions, I have an instrument here called a hydrolab. On one end of the hydrolab, we have those probes that are exposed to the solution and analyze specific parameters, one specialized probe for each. On the other end, we have a computer screen that displays the data. Okay, let's take a measurement of the Coke first. Where did you think Coke is on the pH scale? More acidic or more basic? Can you estimate a number? How close was your estimate? If you have ever had a dentist tell you to drink less soda or juice, it's because the higher acid can eat away at the protective covering on your teeth, causing cavities. Now, let's take a look at the coffee and make some more estimates. Did anyone guess that would be higher than 7? Liquids with a higher pH are not usually things we drink and include chemicals like ammonia and bleach. Finally, let's measure the Las Vegas wash water. Any more guesses? I bet you guys are getting pretty good at this. So, it is pretty close to neutral. It looks like the wash has a healthy pH level, which is good considering it's a home for more than 900 different species of wildlife. Now you have an idea of what is hydrology is and why taking measurement is so important to understand how healthy of our water system are. We have to collect and analyze water sample regularly from strategic locations in order for us to better evaluate and protect our water quality. Now you have an idea of what a hydrology is and why taking measurement is so important to understand how healthy our water system are. We have to collect and analyze water sample regularly from strategic locations in order for us to better evaluate and protect our water quality.